Hope your day is going good. Listen, I wanted to talk about the Donald Trump bringing in the feds. I don't understand. First of all, can you hear me good? Can you guys hear me good? Yes. Okay, thank you. I don't understand why some of us don't really want the feds to come. You know, I post some things up on my Facebook pages, and I also talked about why not? How much longer do we have to wait? How many more of my sisters and brothers and our young children and family members have to lose their lives due to the city violence? And of course, we have black on black crime. It's the truth. A lot of us don't want to hear it, but it's true. Okay, and the truth may hurt. Mary Mitchell inside the Chicago Sun-Times, as she put it, she says, "What are our electors afraid of? Because we had to ask for help? A closed mouth, as they say, would not get fed. So why not ask for help? I know for sure 100%, Chicagoland, we need help. We need so much help that it's ridiculous. Every time you turn on the news, you see some type of violence that's happening. If it's not in our own homes, it's in our schools, okay? Now it actually happened at a visual where people was, showing respect for people that had been killed due to violent crimes and gun crimes. So it's really sad that a lot of us want to just sit back, and just wait and see some kind of miracle is going to happen. The only miracle that's going to happen is if God come down from heavens, okay, and make change. That's the miracle that will happen. But for right now, we need all the help we can. And let me get this straight, you guys. I'm no Donald Trump lover. Okay, let me say that again. I'm no Donald Trump lover, as I stated before. But by all means, if our new president, because he is our president, whether we like it or not, there's nothing anyone can do about it but talk and complain, then sitting here to accept and see what he has to offer. If he does come to Chicago and change the violence on our city streets, I will be more than happy. I will be more than happy because we need it. We need it. And too many lives has been taken, okay? For one of those of you all that don't really know my story, I lost my son due to violence. It wasn't gun violence, but it was city violence. He was only 13 years old in 8th grade, did not get a chance to graduate. And I can tell you this, next month, February 19, makes 10 whole years, 10 whole years, and I still do not have justice on this earth. But I know there's justice in heaven. And that's what keeps me going. But it's not a day that not go by, that doesn't go by, that I don't think about my own child. And I think about the other parents that lost children and the murderers are walking our city streets and not behind bars. So listen, send the National Guards, send the feds, send the army troops, send whatever you have to send in to help with this violence. People do say this, and yes, we do need this. And I post this on my Facebook pages after I post the things that I wanted to say from the heart. Yes, we need more jobs for our youth. Okay. We have a lot of poverty. This is Chicago. Okay. United States of America. We should not have less education for our Black African American students. Okay. The majority. We should not have family members that are, low on income for housing or don't have food. We have less jobs for some of our brothers and sisters, and it's sad. Yes, we do need those things, but on the other hand, we have to stop pointing a finger, point, 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 point. This is the reason why I took a gun, or this is the reason why I took a big knife, or this is the reason why I beat this person to death on Chicago city streets. Stop pointing the damn finger, okay? And turn the finger around at yourself and say, what am I doing to make change within my community or my communities? Because I don't live in the communities where the violence happened, but they don't report everything that happened north where I am living. So crime happens everywhere and it can hit anyone's doorstep at any time. Why? Because it's evil, Okay, I could talk about violence. I don't need notes for this because this is my specialty, okay? This is what I've been doing for the last 10 years. So I don't need notes. Maybe on my other broadcast, I may need notes. But this here, I talk from the heart, from my experience, with my clear conscience, and my clear heart. I am tired of the violence, okay? And I'm sure many of you are tired of the violence as well. But let Donald Trump send the feds, the National Guards, the Army troop, the Marines, whoever he want to send to make change, then let it happen. The other thing is, why did we have to wait so long when we have our officers, we have our lawmakers, we have our Justice Department? Hey, Eric, what's up, my royal? Looking especially beautiful. Oh, I didn't read everything, but thank you. It went so by fast. I don't want to get off my subject. But thank you guys for tuning in. I love you guys. I don't understand why we had to wait in order to get a new president. Yes, we had Obama in office. Thank you, Obama. I love you. Yes. But let me say something. What have anybody did besides Donald Trump to come in and say, we're going to do this and we're going to change? Look, yes, he's building a wall. Okay. Hey, a lot of people are upset. But I'm going to say this. Remember how I spoke on one of my broadcasts when I say action speaks louder than words? Well, guess what? Maybe this president here, okay, is going to put his words to action. Because guess what? I am tired of our electors and our officers saying what they're going to do and nothing has been done. That's not cool. That's not cool at all. I don't know if you guys are tired. I don't know if you guys live in the Chicagoland, but I see violence every single day, okay? And it don't have to be gun violence. I see physical violence with our students. Okay, I work right between two schools, grammar school and a high school. It's violence in all types of forms. And until we understand that it is evildoers walking our city streets, and until we understand that there are murderers walking our city streets, until we understand that no one took a gun and put it to your head and said, go kill this child, go kill this mother, go rape this this old lady that's 78 years old, go rob this man, go in the store and stick up, go in the bank and stick up, then guess what? We have to understand, we got to stop pointing the finger at each other because the world is real. The world is real. Thank you. Thank you, my world. The world is real. Violence exists. It's around us. Some of us have blinders on. Okay, I can't see. Some of us have blinders on our ears. Okay, I can't hear. Okay, it's not in my home. It didn't hit my territory. So what do I give a care for? Well, guess what? It may hit your town. It may hit your home. Until then, you better keep praying and asking Father God to protect you and send his warrior angels to protect you and your family. The crime in the city streets of Chicago is everybody's problem. And I'm going to say this, to each his own, okay? So when I speak from the heart, clear conscience and a clear heart, and from what my experience is by me living in Chicago and by me losing a child due to violence. Okay, let me just say this and let me make myself very clear. We have a lot of people, okay, that is above us, meaning in office. They have not done a damn thing about anything with this violence yet. They may talk and walk, but there's no action. And as I said before in one of my broadcasts, if there's no work with action, you have no works. You can talk all day long. So I am allowing as a Chicago citizen for Donald Trump, okay, to come in and make change in Chicagoland because we need it. And I'm going to tell you again, I'm no Trump lover, okay, but I will be a lover if he come in here and stop this crime on our city streets of our children. See, I always said that the enemy has destroyed our young generation, and I've been saying that for years, but no one took Pamela serious. No one thought that everything was going to be just like it is right now. We're steady losing our babies. This is a Chicago paper, you guys. Sometimes for those of you that do not live in the Chicago area, everything in here in this paper just about today is about our violence on the city streets. Everybody is in an uproar about Donald Trump coming in to bring the fast to try and stop this violence. But let me ask the people that have a problem. What are they doing about it? What are you doing about it? What are you doing about the violence? Is your governor doing anything to help Chicago? Is our own mayor doing anything to help Chicago? Yes, we got a new vice attendant for the police in our district. But yeah, they should have kept what we had in office, okay? Because nothing changed. Only thing I can see, the crime rate went up higher. Because you thought you could just move people around, and then I'm thinking you just coming in like this with your belts up high, your pants up high. You ain't did a damn thing to make a change. So stop putting a finger, okay, on Donald Trump that's trying to make a difference in Chicago right here. Stop doing it. Let the president take a stand and let him make action to his words. Let him put works to his words. That's what I'm talking about. I'm keeping it real, y'all. Okay? I'm keeping it real. Because if he's going to make change, I want the change. I want the help. I'm tired of my family members, my sisters and brothers. You all are all my sisters and brothers in Christ. I am so sick and tired of my sisters and brothers getting murdered on the city streets. Yes, you guys are my sisters and brothers through Christ. Okay? We all came from one person. Okay? Yes, we have our regular father and mother, but God plans to see on everything. People really need to be careful hating who God loves. Yes, absolutely. You're right. And it's really sad, because whatever God do not want to happen, guess what? Maybe it wouldn't happen. No more room for being politician correction or talking politics correct. That's true. That's true. And I only talk what I know, but the problem is, if we get somebody that's willing to make change, let them do what they need to do and stop shooting them down. Stop pointing a finger. Let's see what he has to offer around the world, not just for Chicago, but for around the world, because a lot of us are losing family members. You can live over here, you can live over here, but I'm quite sure everybody got somebody that lives in Chicago. Hello, I got my family that lives in California. I got family that live in Texas. I got family that live in South Carolina. I mean, come on. We have to give him a chance, because I'm tired of the violence. And now it made me question myself. I'm kind of confused about some of you guys' comments on my Facebook page. Because you guys first say, I mean, not my comments, but some of the comments that was on Facebook last night. I'm kind of confused. I thought you guys wanted help. First, you guys didn't want the National Guards. Duh, we should have had the National Guards when they wanted to bring them in. You know why? Maybe if we would have gave it a chance and stopped being in such an uproar, maybe some of our family members will still be here. Okay? Stop. Give people time. Let's see what they can do. Because I really honestly think if he's in process of building this wall, okay, over in Mexico, and he's telling us Chicagolands, get it together before he send a fast, then we need to get it together. We need to do something. It's going to take more than one person. It's going to take your community to stand up. Now, I forgot the young man that was on the news this morning. They had him on. He wrote a book, one of the brothers. He said, oh, maybe they should send the National Guards in. Oh, because maybe they can bring in more jobs. So let me tell you something, because I didn't get your name, but I could go back and watch the newscast and get your name. Let me say this to you. We have March. Okay, we went down on Michigan Avenue. Okay, our only one, okay, pastor, Reverend Father Mike, he does everything. Okay, how many pastors do we got in Chicagoland? I can't even count it. So many, but how many is doing something about it, coming behind their closed doors and walking the city streets with us, parents, and all of us? How many people? How many people? And how many pastors? One pastor in Chicago. Okay. And I thank you and I love you for doing what you do for us as Chicago citizens. So don't say we should march. We do march. Okay. But march is not going to get it. We can march to kingdom come. Okay. And let it be done. Doesn't mean anything. It's not going to stop a person from pulling the trigger. Now I'm going to go here, and I don't care who don't like this. I need a little tea right now. Hold on. Let me say this about the guns, and I'm going to broadcast it because I did it before and I'm going to do it again. My young brothers that's on the city streets, whatever they may be doing to make a dollar or whatever, or some money for their families. Let me say this. The guns are being brought in, okay, from my understanding, on the freight trains, okay, on different areas of Chicago. They taking the guns off the train, and they're putting it on our city streets. And the thing about that is, it's being distributed to everybody that wants a gun. So we have all these guns, okay? So now they're killing each other. Another thing, my very own brothers, they're getting the guns from someone that is driving by, distributing them to give them the guns, and they're paying for them. Somebody's doing that. Where are the guns coming from? Ask yourself that. Here's another thing, okay, that I found out. Lost a change of thought. The guns are not only on our city streets, but the guns has also entered the churches, into our schools, into our museums, into our CTA buses. There's guns everywhere. So who's supposed to hike up the security? Us as citizens? I don't think so. Do your job that you are put to do when you're in office. Because you're best to believe if I ever get a chance to get in office, I'm gonna do my job and more than my job. I'm not gonna sit on my bottom behind a desk and not help my people. I'm not going to do that. Because that means you're not doing your job and taking it serious and loving one another and not just loving yourself. God don't want that. He don't want you to be a selfish lover. He don't want you to keep everything to yourself. You gotta go out and teach. Go out and be a teacher. You gotta go out and be an example. Okay? We need that more than anything. Listen, it's so much violence. I don't know if you guys saw this video on a school bus. The school bus was parked. This girl got up, hit this girl because she threw a water bottle at her, and just constantly beat her in the head. That's another form of violence, okay? We have an individual driving around in a truck, two males, giving candy, asking little boys, "You want candy?" Trying to take our children away. See, violence come in all types of forms. My people, we need to wake up. We need to pray. You're right, Aurora. You're totally right. That is so true. But you know what? A lot of people don't understand. They don't understand. They think you could just sit at home and not do anything. We cannot do that. We have to be a voice for the people because some of us cannot be a voice. Some of us can't talk. Some of us are shy. Well, you know what? It's time to be unshy. Okay, it's time. Do your best. Whatever you got, make that your platform. If you could get up and dance and do a hallelujah dance and do a worship dance, do that. Whatever you have as a platform, use it to your full advantage. Make change in your life. Make change in somebody else's life. I am so sick of our sisters and brothers dying. And because of the visual that happened just overnight, and the gunman came in the crowd and started shooting, that's crazy. Next month, I will be having a press conference at my office for my son 10 years with no justice. I'm not going to jeopardize nobody's life. Not saying in the last 9 years, nothing ever happened over there on Lawrence and Troy, but I'm not going to do it. I am going to be indoors, and I am going to say what I want to say to the press about not having justice for 10 years for my son, and murderers are walking our city streets. I'm not going to take anybody on Lawrence and Troy with me. I'm going to go myself because that's how much my child means to me. And if it's my time, then it's my time. Hallelujah, glory to God. I will accept it, but I am not going to be a closed mouth. I'm not going to be a parent that's not going to stand up for my child justice or any other person or individual family member or mother justice. Okay, it is too much time that has been wasted on our Chicago city streets with violence. There is no way we should have waited this long for someone to really step in and say something. Now everybody is in an uproar. Why are you in an uproar? Relax. Okay, clear your conscience, clear your heart, pray, and let's see what this man has to offer for us as a new president. I don't know how plain and simple to say it, but it's real. They know it's the ridiculous of our people. No unity. That's true. We don't have unity, and we need that. We need that so much that it's unbelievable. But some people don't know how to have unity. Listen, if you can't love yourself, how can you love somebody else? How can we love somebody else? It's hard for individuals to even love themselves every day. People get up, look in the mirror, be like, I hate myself. They don't care about probably even washing up in the morning. So how are you gonna be a light to somebody else? Love your spirit, keep giving to them. Yes, we have to. We cannot help an individual. We have to help ourselves and love ourselves first. We have to do that. We got to stop looking down. We got to stop looking up for God's grace, mercy, and the Holy Spirit to lead us. They're looking down because when you look down, it's nothing but the pits of hell. Some people walk down like this. We have to walk up and embrace what God has to offer for us. Let Him know that we are open. We are open. We need your help. We need y'all. We need any help that God is going to send to us right now. It may put a damp on Chicago. Ooh, Chicago had to have the National Guards come in. Guess what? Or the National Feds, the Feds. I'd rather for Chicago to be relaxed and have the Feds come in if that's what it's going to take, than reading in the headlines and on the news and being number one in the United States of violence. I'd rather, because who want to see that every day? So let's take a stand, okay? Let's get together, okay? And let's make change with among each other by starting out loving yourself, loving your neighbor, okay? And let's see what happens from that. Stop pointing a finger at other individuals saying, my brothers don't have jobs. My brother's on drugs. My brother's don't have nowhere to live. My brother's is raping people because they sick in the head. Well, yeah, that happens all the time. But listen, that does not lead and does not make it right for somebody to go out and shoot our children, shoot our family members because they're having a life that they didn't choose to have. Okay, but some of them choose to have by choice. But we got to stop pointing a finger. It's no excuse. It's no excuse. It's no excuse. And I'm sorry, I'm not making excuses for people. I'm not making excuses for people. Let me tell y'all something. You think when my son got murdered, if I wasn't in the spirit realm, I would have, okay, no telling what I would have done. I got big family members, okay? It ain't no secret. Everybody got some goons in their family. I don't know what kind of spirit world I could have not been in to not have me go out there and do harm to others. I'm not gonna do that. I don't wanna do that. Anyone can have a reason, yeah. But there's no excuse. It doesn't make it right. Nobody makes it right. There's no righteousness of coming from murdering people. Everybody knows about Chicago. It ain't no secret. Yes, I am ashamed. I'm ashamed of Chicago and how it has become. I'm ashamed. Let me say this. Spike Lee came out and did the movie in Chicago, Chi-Rock. Guess what? Did not change. The violence went up. Okay? Let Donald Trump do what he do. And let me say that again. I am no Trump lover. But if he's gonna come in and make change, then let it happen. That's all I want to say today. I am just tired. Okay? We need to break some change. Chains. Some of us need some chains broke in our lives. Some of us need to do something, okay? We need to make a difference. We need to believe. We need to keep our faith. We don't need to lose our hope. He's there now. We can't do anything about it. And there's nothing we can do about it, period. We will have to accept. And yes, we do. And keep it in prayer because we have to give a chance. We have to give an individual a chance. We have to give them a chance to rebuild our kingdom. Okay? We don't have to be overwhelmed with it, but we have to give them a chance to rebuild our kingdoms. Okay? There's no other way. You know, we got to set a fire through the throne just to see what can happen. You know, you can't just light something and don't try to light and start a fire. We have to try. We have to speak up. If I get a chance to meet Donald Trump, if I do, these will be my two things that I will ask Donald Trump for. And I mean this from the bottom of my heart. President Donald Trump, if you can please, for 10 years, 10 years, I have been fighting for justice for my son, Lazarus Jones. For 10 years, I have not seen the violence cease at all. I have seen the violence climb a mountain and over the mountain, over another mountain, the mountain of many youth that's been murdered. Can you stop the violence on our city streets? I will shake his hand and say, thank you, God, be with us all, and walk away. Hell, I probably won't even want a picture. I'm just keeping it real, you guys. Enough is enough. Stop saying he's gonna do this or I don't like him for his women's rights. Okay, neither do I. But the thing is, give him a chance to make change. I don't see nobody else stepping up to the plate making change. I don't see our mayor, Ron Emanuel, making change. I don't see it. And remember that God is still God and he still sits on the throne. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely, thank you. And we have to understand that. I'm just tired, you guys. I don't know if you guys tired, but I am tired. I'm tired. I am very tired. But I'm not going to let it stop me from being who I am and taking away all of this strength that I have from what happened in my life and not share to others. I'm not going to let it do it. You don't look tired. Thank you, my royal. In the Bible, God uses a donkey. He could surely use Donald Trump. You know what? That's good. If you want to put it that way, ha ha, I'm with you on that one. Absolutely. Because we need it. And you guys, let's just pray for change. Let's just pray that things will happen. You know, and not just in Chicago, but around the whole world, because all of us are affected by our new president. We have to see what's going to happen. And we have to stop pointing a finger at each other, blaming each other, because we can't blame each other, because it's really no one's fault as an individual, as a United States citizen. I blame our leaders. Because they are the ones that's in charge. We're not in charge. We don't work in the White House. We don't stand behind the doors in the police station. We don't have these authorities to do something. But as a citizen, you can vote and you can use your voice and let it be heard and take it to your platform as far as you can. And that's what we can do as citizens. Remember that. Use your platform of what you have and let it shine with God's light of love and make change in people's lives. That's what I want to leave with you guys today. Thank you for the hearts. Thank you so much. I love you guys. Until next time, peace, love, and joy to everybody with love. I love you guys. Use your voice. You are so right, Flower. Use your voice. Thank you guys so much. I'm going out with the song, There Will Be a Day. Okay, when change will come.
It's never been a step, but you've walked down all alone. Troubled soul, don't lose your heart, 'cause joy and peace he brings, and the beauty that's in store. How is the hurt of life sting? But I hold on to this hope and the promise that he brings.
Peace, love, and joy always. Bye.